Welcome to Campbell University School of Osteopathic Medicine. I'm Grace Brennan, and I'm the current Research Associate Dean for Campbell Medicine. Research at Campbell Medicine is a prerequisite to excellence in teaching and creating an atmosphere for learning. It is a mechanism for our faculty, residents, and students to contribute to the medical literature to advance optimal patient care. At Campbell Medicine, we engage in basic science, clinical research, educational research, and more. In addition to a vivarium and other shared laboratory space on the main campus, researchers have access to the Campbell Hall of Science Research Space and the Bryan Hall Research Facility. Combined, these two spaces total 3,000 square feet. Currently, these two spaces house our Human Performance Lab and Basic Science Laboratories. The research space at Tracey F. Smith Hall is our newest addition and adds approximately 7,000 square feet designated for medical research. Smith Hall is a modern molecular and cellular biology laboratory. It has a core facility with resources in a shared capacity. It has full microbiology, fluorescence microscopy, protein, RNA, DNA analysis, and small molecule separation capabilities, just to name a few. It has a room designed for use with radioactive and controlled substances. There are 14 lab benches with 28 workstations. The laboratory has a biosafety level 2 designation. Learners have the opportunity to engage in mentored research year-round. We also have a summer research scholars program that is open to rising second-year medical students. There is a wide variety of studies that students or residents can be part of. One example is the development of a novel transformation procedure to modify the mitochondrial genome. Another example is determining the effects of plasticizers in Leydig cells, which produce testosterone.
Hello, my name is Oleg Alexeev, and I'm the professor in the QSOM. And I'm very proud and happy to do research here. I do this research for 5 years since I came in the school, and we are investigating the opportunity to use NASP, nuclear autoantigenic sperm protein, for the early detection of the cancers. We started only with one tumor, that was the prostate cancer. Last year, we expanded that one, and we shown that out of 10 most common tumors based on the Center for Disease Control, 60% of them can be early detected using our protein. And our students won the first prize in the American College of Physicians last year. We were invited to present our research in Denmark in the European Association for Medical Oncology. This year we have two students who are even doing more expanded research. We added 15 more tumors and working primarily with the pancreatic cancer and liver cancer, and we are expecting for the best possible result. Thank you.
Our group is developing a method to transform mitochondria, which is to try to alter the DNA sequence. Ultimately, we would like to investigate the role of mitochondria in some major human diseases, such as cancer. And ultimately, we would like to be able to develop more effective and better treatments.
Hi, I'm Dr. Hinkleman, and in our lab, we're very interested in understanding better how our immune system either protects or contributes to disease, especially in response to infection. And one of the things that we do know is during viral respiratory infections, a lot of times, yes, the viral pneumonia itself can cause disease, but we also see a lot of high elevated sickness as well as death caused by a secondary bacterial infection. And so one of the things that we're looking at is how do macrophages, a type of immune cell, respond when you expose them to a virus followed by a bacterium, and looking at inflammatory mediators so we can better understand how in cases like flu, which is a significant pathogen every year, how we can better understand that disease process and maybe even lead to better treatments and management of patients.
The goal of the Smith Hall Lab is to expand our research collaborations and also increase our research productivity in the form of faculty, student, resident presentations, publications, and extramural grants. This new lab will build upon the successes of current Campbell Medicine NIH grants on sepsis, protecting against cancer chemotherapy-induced chronic heart failure, and identification of novel therapeutic targets for the treatment of endocannabinoid-mediated disorders such as Parkinson's or epilepsy. This space also provides our residency programs additional capabilities to meet and exceed ACGME accreditation requirements. Above all, our goal is for Campbell Medicine research to contribute to the improvement of health of patients in North Carolina, the nation, and the world.